We wanted to look into our data and analyze the impact of different biologic agents of the improvement of on the improvement of fatigue. So the data source for our analysis was the German Biologics Register Rabbit. In this register that also started in 2001, like the British Register, as we just heard, patients with rheumatoid arthritis are included when they start either a treatment with a biologic agent or when they start a treatment with a conventional DMARD after at least one DMARD failure. And once enrolled, patients are observed for at least 5 years and up to 10 years, no matter what treatment changes they have in the future. So at regular time points during this follow-up, at the beginning it's every 3 months and then later on every 6 months, the treating rheumatologists and the patients report details about the actual treatment, about medication, co-medication, comorbidities, disease activities, adverse events, and all kinds of other things. Among them, fatigue, which is reported from the patients on a scale from 0, meaning no fatigue, to 10, a very high fatigue. At baseline, at inclusion in our register, 89% of the patients reported that they have fatigue. From all the patients in the register that are nowadays 9,500, we included in this analysis only 5,400 patients that had at least 6 months of follow-up and that had a minimum of 2 DMARD failures before they went on another conventional DMARD to make them better comparable to the biologics-treated group. Then we first compared the frequency of patients under these various treatments regarding reaching a state of no fatigue at 6 months or having experienced a clinically significant improvement. And we defined this clinically significant improvement as a decrease in the reported fatigue of 3 points or more. Improvement of fatigue was seen under all treatments, DMARD and biologic treatments, but it was significantly more reported in patients that were treated with biologics. And the highest proportion of patients without fatigue was found in those treated with anti-TNF treatment or tocilizumab, a treatment that inhibits interleukin-6. Factors influencing the improvement of fatigue were disease activity, functional capacity, comorbidities, and we saw that patients without comorbidities have a 40% higher chance of reaching no fatigue in all treatment groups than patients with any comorbidity. Another factor was previous treatment with biologics. Every treatment failure reduces the chance for the next treatment to improve fatigue. Also, pain and morning stiffness above 30 minutes have an influence on the improvement of fatigue. Adjusted for all these factors, our multiple logistic regression that we did then showed that the chance of a clinically significant improvement is significantly higher under biologic treatment compared to conventional DMARD treatment. Secondly, the chance of reaching a state of no fatigue is seen to be significantly higher for patients treated with anti-TNF treatments. And also for tocilizumab-treated patients. Through getting high disease activity under control, all the other treatments as well have the chance to improve fatigue, but our hypothesis is, due to our results, that there might be a direct effect of anti-TNF treatment and tocilizumab treatment on fatigue, because we did also another analysis where we controlled for the controlling of disease activity. So we also found that the improvement of fatigue under those treatments was faster than on getting high disease activity under control. Improvement of fatigue was reached faster than improvement of disease activity. And these results are supported by experimental findings. Georg Schett and his group, they did an experimental mouse model, and they could show that the blockade of TNF-alpha had a direct effect on the central nervous system, and they were looking especially after pain, but fatigue also is said to originate in the brain. And so we we thought that might be have the same effect maybe. To conclude, treatment with biologics improve fatigue significantly and more frequently than conventional DMA treatment, and especially treatments blocking cytokines like TNF-alpha and interleukin-6 seem to be more effective in improving fatigue.